It was to be a dreamer. But you know I found.
And welcome to beautiful Dallas, Texas. And you are watching a production of Dallas Assists Basketball in this exhibition game, the Dallas Assists against the Ambassador Athletic Works. And this is an exhibition game that is a part of the Texas Basketball Association. The voice that you'll hear on camera today is Channing Humphrey, your usual host for Semi-Pro Live. And we'll be coming in to tap in for some live action today.
Hey, Bubba.
Number two to inbound the ball after it was knocked out of bounds. Pass gets it in the post, easy bucket, and the assist get the first score of the game. Makes a move, kicks it out to the screen, wide open three, misses it. Dallas assists with the rebound, number 15 coming down, passes up to the top of the key, makes a move into the paint, and good. Dallas assists, taking the old school method, getting into the paint for some early points. Number two gets caught up. He's going to shoot for three. Wide open three. In and out. Into the paint again. He's going to miss this one. Rebound by number three. And he's going to take it down for Athletic Works. Makes a move. Puts up a ball. In and out. And the shot is not falling thus far for Athletic Works. Drives to the middle of the lane, finds an opening, and he's able to get the first points of the game for the Athletic Works. Dallas has had some success in the paint. Their point guard goes in the end. He's got the foul. Let's see if he gets the and one. Two. New score 7-2. Dallas assists off to the early lead. Makes a move. Coming around the wing. Not a lot of passing going on. And number two is able to get it back up. Your new score 4-7. Makes a move. Don't worry about it. Shoots the three. First three attempt of the game for Dallas assists. Lose control of that one, but his partner's there to pick up the scraps. And that three is not going to fall. Dallas just gets a rebound, coming close to close with their point guard, passes it off, tries to oop, passes it back out to the big man, shoots it out further, and fouled on the drive in. Okay. 11-7, Athletic Works are trying to keep up. There hasn't been much passing. That is only the fourth pass of the game. Fifth pass of the game. Unable to get the bucket, but he draws the foul. And he'll shoot the first free throw shot for Athletic Works. And one thing I'm noticing, they're going to have to spend some more time in that painted area if they're going to try and draw even from the free throw line. Your score is 11-7. Most of the points for the Dallas assists have been dirty points out of the paint. And there's going to be a sub in, switching out the big man for the Dallas assists. Number 32 is going to come out on the court for the first time today, along with number 4 and number 77. And he makes both of his shots. We're having a new score here as soon as they update the clock for us. Passes out to the wing. Takes the shot as soon as he gets in. There's a good look. In and out. Maybe he just needs a little bit more time to warm up. The point guard of the Athletic Works bringing it down. Shoots the three. And I have to say, this shot has been broke from three all day. But luckily his teammates able to get the rebound and put it back in. They've drawn even. Oh, and number one gets a three right when the Dallas assist needed, bringing their score back out to four. Quickly down the court, in and out in the paint. Dallas assist back with possession of the ball. And let's see if they look to slow this one down or step on the gas. Number two crosses the man. Had a nice look, unable to complete it. Oh, with the and one. And the Dallas assists are just playing good fundamental basketball at this point. They're getting all the paint points. They're getting to the free throw line. And they're playing solid defense. And it shows on the scoreboard. Ambassador Athletic Works coming down the court. New point guard, number 11, brings it down. Hands it off to number one. Makes the move. He's driving to the paint. Looks like he got a foul. That'll be and one. And that's the best paint work we've seen all day from out of the Athletics Works. And I like what I saw there. They need to get a little bit more ball movement, and they can have the same type of result every time they come down the court. But I feel like they're starting to ease into the game a little bit more. That's why the score is drawing a little bit more even. Comes down the court, passes it off. Great screen. It was a good look, but not a great shot. Big man can't handle the pass. Athletics Works has another chance with the ball, bringing it down court. Don't waste the possession. He drives straight to the hoop, and he can't make the layup. He had a great look. Brings it down the court. Crosses a man, puts up a three. Off the mark, 77, wide open look. He's gonna dribble drive. And he's good for the outside too. 34, finds some room in the paint, passes it off, 3-point attempt. Good look, just not able to, those shots just haven't been falling very much for them in this one. Gets the ball off. Hells gets it back out to the wing, good open three look, and the three is good. Dallas' assists have been hot from all over the court today. Ma'am, would it be okay if you sat on this side of the camera? We're filming. We're filming the court for right here. Sorry about that. Dallas assist coming down the court. Looks like he takes a look from the top of the key. In and out, it was a good look. Athletic Works choosing to slow it down. Gets it back to their point guard. They're slowing this one down, trying to set something up. Or this is straight ISO. He takes him and he gets in the paint and makes it happen. Number two, leading scorer for the Athletic Works today. Dallas assist point guard, passes it into the paint. Open look, makes it count. And number seven has some success since he came off the bench earlier in this matchup. Leading scorer for the Athletic Works, number two, makes a man move. Finds a little bit of space. The shot's good. It looks like he's gonna get some free throws. And I like what I've seen from him today. He's been real aggressive. He didn't have the early success that you want to see from your point guard, but he's been able to make it happen today. Now, what I want to see is more shot attempts from his teammates from inside. I turned 32 a couple of days ago. Maybe it's just the old school in me. But the Dallas assists are up to an early lead with all paint money. Number zero passes it out to the wing. Makes a move. Tries to go up and under. Fouled on the attempt. That's going to be, it looks like it's going to be free throw shots for number 15 of the Dallas assists. Unable to convert the first attempt. Your score 24-18. With the shot. And he goes 1-for-1. Score 25-18, 34 drives, takes a shot from the three, and they have not had very much success from the three-point line outside of number two. These other players are going to have to get in the paint. I understand why they're hesitant to take those inside shots. The Dallas assists have a sizable height advantage if you're just looking on the court player for player.
Oh, physical play. And he's able to draw the foul. It's gonna be two shots. Number zero has been very physical in the paint today. He's only taken one shot outside of the key. Passes it out. And they're gonna restart this one with the point guard. Oh, he's going ISO. Oh, a steal. And the layup is good. Dallas assists, continuing to put on the defensive pressure. Makes a move, number 30, another steal. Sloppy basketball going on for Athletic Works. Number two puts up another three, and at this point, they are just throwing up shots. They have got to get in this paint. They are not going to have the success they want to have by shooting all these threes. Good look by the assist. Let's see if they get in the paint on this one. And it looks like that's going to be a travel as he passes the ball to himself. Hey, the Dallas assist, this isn't a first-year program. They have a little bit of the history of success and excellence. You can see the difference in the ages of the programs here on the court. Find some space in the paint. Nice up and over layup. Number 20 brings the ball down for Athletic Works. Passes it out to number 11 to the wing. And a great frequent look and make. As number 10 has had the hot hand from three since he's come on the court. Oh, and he comes right back down and answers. Man, pushing their lead out to the original. Three missed. And let's see if the assists get three happier. They're going to find some more room in the paint. He gets down, throws one up. Not a good look. He probably should have passed that one out. And watch out for number 20. He's been hot. Shoots the three, makes the three. Correction, not number 20, number 10. Dallas assist, trying to find some space. Let's see if he passes this one out. Find some room on the key. He's driving, going baseline. Good look. And with the make on the layup, which just scored a 41, number 11's right back down. And they are really pushing the pace in this matchup. Puts up a three, unable to convert. Wide open man on the other end. Fakes the three, passes down low. Good ball movement. As number six doesn't take the selfish play and gives it up to the big man in the post. And you see the results. As we have our first timeout of the game, your score 40-24, Dallas assists. With the rebound, gonna put it back up. Not a very good look. Good rebound by the post. not a very good possession by the Dallas defense. They are up by almost 20 in the quarter. Good defense, though. Whatever they may have been lacking on that last possession, they brought it all day on the defensive side of the court. As they've been able to hold their opponents only 20 points. Great offense. Let's see if Athletic Works can tap into some defense. Good defense by number 30. Number two with another shot. He's really been the hot hand in this matchup.
Thank you.
with the crossover. Illich by a shot. Number two drives the ball down the court. Number one taking a far three. And I am not understanding some of the shot selection, as he was over 3 feet behind the three-point line. Good defense in the paint. Gonna result in the foul, though. Number 11 is going to sub out for number 6, getting on the court for the first time today. And it's 6-on-6. This match, Zero's got gets a good shot up. Unable to convert, but he will get free throw shots. Seconds left to go in the half. Your score 43-31. Number 30 with the score. And he converts the first. By a shot. He probably should have passed that one away. And gets up a shot. Looks like there's going to be a foul under the basket on the rebound. And Athletic Works will maintain possession. Dallas assists with a 10-point lead here. Oh, nice step forward. Looks like he's going to be just short of a three. Number 6 taking the ball down court. Looks like they're trying to press him. Watch for the dribble drive penetration. Drives to the paint. Gets the shot up. 2 attempts at the rebound. 3 attempts, unable to come down. Athletic Works gets the ball down on the wing. Number 77 with the rebound. And a whistle on the play. What's that going to be? And a timeout. Dallas assists. All right. While we have a quick second, I want to give a quick shout out to all the Dallas Assist sponsors. The Oak Cliff Muscle Factory. Shout out to Burroughs Used Cars, located in Dallas, Texas. If you're looking for a new vehicle or a vehicle for your kids or a family member, give them a call. And we're back after the commercial break. Since coming out of the timeout, they will have possession. Ball in. Number 77's been hot when he's had the ball in his hands. Puts up a three. Good defense. Oh, and the postman number 2. One dribble and puts it back up. Number one, the big man at the top of the key. Not much. There's not enough ball movement on the Athletic Works sideline. It seems like a lot of selfish plays, a lot of one dribble shots, and they need to just get the ball moving more so they get higher percentage shots. Oh, almost gets it in, but he'll get the foul nonetheless. And the Dallas assists are at the free throw line. Once again today, sorry about the horns in the background. Makes the free throws look easy. Number 30 bringing the ball down the court. Looks like they switched up point guards. Going to go with a different approach as number two has went to the bench. And already, I have to say, I like the change of pace now that number 32 is bringing the ball down. And he immediately tries to get into the paint. A little bit of a bigger lineup here for the Athletic Works. Let's see if they look to get in the paint more. I don't know. I like the change. I like number 30 with the point guard role. As he goes one for one. And the Dallas assists immediately in the paint, gets the ball up, rebound by the center. He's gonna bring it back out. I feel like he should have went back up with that. And the ball is stolen on the key, in the paint, and with the money, Athletic Works have changed up the pace a little bit, and they are getting in the paint, and the last two possessions have been scores. And the post is trapped over on the wing, and he steps out of bounds. Good defense, and this new lineup has added a little bit more aggression for the Athletic Works, and you're starting to see the results on the court already. Dallas assist play has been sloppy for about the last 3 minutes of this contest. Let's see if they can tighten it up on defense. Into the paint, a little bit more ball movement, and this is what's going to get them better shots. And again, oh, it's stolen. Number four gets the ball. Number seven tries the teardrop layup, unable to make it go in. Getting a little bit sloppy with the ball handling for the assist. Long three, long make. And that's exactly what the assist needed to maintain their lead. Number 30 back at point. Let's see if he looks to get some more penetration. He's getting doubled at the top. Good mismatch. Gets around to the wing, puts up a shot. Good look, unable to get it to fall. Another three-point attempt. And number one is hot as the post has moved outside. And he's having success at that wing position. Your new score, 53-38. Oh, with the steal. Assist turning up the defense. And our first dunk of the game. Swings it out to the wing.
Stay him up.
77 at the top of the key. Drives to the inside, gets it out to number one. He's been hot. And he drops another one. Number one is on fire. And they're going to call a timeout. Been hot from three all day. He's now four out of five from the three-point line. Well, while we got this quick timeout, let's get another word from our from our sponsors, Oak Cliff Muscle Factory, a great athletic facility helping young men around the greater Dallas area get in shape and get ready for their optimal athletic performance. But back on the court, just a quick 20-second timeout. They're going to switch out at point again. Number 4 is going to run point at this point. I like what number 30 brought to the table. It looks like they're going to want to get him more at shooting guard.
Number 30 was open.
Moore passed it up. He brings it in himself.
Come on.
Unable to land the up and under. Number 15 had a wide open look. Those paint draws the foul. And he's able to get to the free throw line, and this is exactly the type of plays that the Athletic Works needs to make if they're going to get back into this game. Still plenty of time in this matchup. Still in the second quarter, 5 minutes, 21 seconds left to go on this one. Your score is 56-38. Number 15, first of two shots. Second of two shots. Unable to convert the second shot. Number 0 brings it down the court, passes it out to the wing. He's going to drive it as well. And 1. He's able to drive in, get penetration, and convert the shot. He goes 2 of 2 from the free throw line. And number 30 will take the point. I like what he's been able to do at the point guard position so far today. So let's see if we can convert. Oh, and he is ripped. And a travel before the assist to get it going. Number 2 at the top of the key. Makes a man miss. Pass it out to the side. Into the paint. And he's got a good look. Able to convert the up and under. Number 23 added to the game. Number 23 and 15 definitely add some size for the Athletic Works. And you start to see it on defense. Number 2 back to the point. Oh, a good pass. Great assist by number 2. Number 4 out on the wing. Crosses his man over. Loses the ball. Gets a shot up. Illich by shot. Ball still in play. And he gets ripped on the wing. Athletic Works, they got 3-on-2. Easy layup. And the added big man have been the difference in this game. Number 23 has really made it hard for the Dallas assists to get those early pain points that they were getting in the first quarter. Has completely dried up for the assist. Oh, good defense. Number 0 able to get the rim before he can take it up. But he'll send his man to the free throw line. Their score 59-45. The game is not out of control by any means. Dallas assist coming around the corner. He puts up a long three. He makes a long three. 48-59, Athletic Works. makes a move. He needs to pass this one out. And he waits too long. And the sloppy play is getting to the Dallas assist. And they have to tighten this up. The sloppy play on offense is what's costing. Number zero had been having a great game up until that moment. And number four, he's gonna bring it back out. Mayer coming with the pressure defense. Finds the opening, eats it. And another and one. And the athletic works have started to turn it on, finding chemistry here in the second quarter. Their new score, 50, the Dallas assist 59. The Ambassadors Athletic Works, 50.
I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Number 23, the big man, unable to convert. Still got the and one. Still nice play. 2 minutes and 16 seconds. A crucial mistake. Puts up the shot. From three. Dallas just with the ball back, they're driving it back down the court. And they've got to get back in the paint, which they immediately do. Sloppy pass, and the offense, you can really see as the fatigue starts to set in for the Dallas assist. Their ball handling is becoming sloppier and sloppier. Pass out to 77. Drives to the middle, gets an open look. Easy layup. As number two takes it down the court, crosses the man, drives to the middle, tries to convert the style, unable to. Tosin able to convert the style, number 30 with the ball. Pass it out, down to 50 to steal. Pass the ball to number four, and a wrestle at the bottom. Down in the post, and that'll be shots again. Number four makes it to the free throw line. Oh, it's going to be an up down. I don't care, Jazz. Mm-hmm. Athletic works, passes over to number four in the wing. Stutter step. And he tries to shoot it to the post. Ball stolen. 77, one-on-one. And he gets the and one. Seconds left to go here in the half. Your score is 64-53. And once again, we are out here. This is a part of the Texas Basketball Association, an exhibition game between the Dallas Assist and the Ambassadors Athletic Works. 2 of 2 free throws. 30 seconds to go. And let's see if they slow this one down and try to compete for the last shot. Move to his right, move to his left. Gets into the paint, dishes it out to the wing, up to the top of the key. 15 makes a move. He's gonna reset. Number 11, dribble drive penetration. Nobody home in the middle. And that was a complete waste of possession. 7.6 seconds left to go here in the quarter. And the Dallas Ambassadors will have a chance with the last shot here. He drives down the sideline. He steps out of bounds. And two crucial mistakes back to back. Pass number 30. He makes a move on one. Obvious foul. It was missed. Puts up. Tell him to follow the ball. And that'll end your halftime. Well, stay tuned in. We'll have a special message from one of the Dallas Assist keynote sponsors as we enjoy our halftime presentation.
This is Channing Humphrey with Semi-Pro Live. We have a little bit of a special treat. I'm here with the co-owners of Yoplit Muscle Factory. We have Edward and Monique here, and they are the co-owners. They can give us a little bit more information about their fine facility, where it's located, and the different programs they offer. So we're going to start ladies first, and then we'll pass it over to Edward, and we'll go ahead and get started. So, man, tell me, where's your gym location, and what do you guys specialize in? Are you guys a boxing gym, or do you cater to all different types of athletes?
We cater to all different kinds. It's located
at 1039 North Ravinia Drive. That's Dallas 75211. We're a 24/7 facility, so our members have access to the gym all the time. And we have different weights in there. You can either do CrossFit or regular workouts. We have actual machines too. We also offer Zumba Monday through Thursday at 6:30 p.m. And we sell teas and shakes too. We have a smoothie bar.
Okay. Now, how long have you guys been in existence, and when did you guys establish the gym?
We opened like the last week of August. We've got about almost a year now, a couple months. Like you said, it's a 24/7 hour gym. Whenever you want, once you become a member, we'll give you a code to the door. It doesn't matter the time you come or the day you come. Everybody's welcome. Like you said, we also work out with athletes, baseball, football, any athletes. We got out there, we got everything out there. We got some tires out there that they can flip. We got a big sled, the big guys out there. So if you're ever out there and no clip, check us out.
Okay. Do you guys have any social media or a website that we can get in contact with you?
We're mainly on Instagram and Facebook. It's Oakland Muscle Factory. Just our name.
Is there a phone number?
I think you can do it 469-734-0793. You can either call me or text me. If you have any information, just let me know. Or just through the Instagram page too.
We also have day passes too. So if anyone recommends you, we offer day passes.
They're free.
What,
do you guys have a monthly membership or what are the rates
on those? So memberships are $35 a month, but your first time is always free. And then if we can give you like 3 or 4 different day passes too.
Okay. Well, hey, we're going to look forward to get out there. Maybe we'll get to film some commercials for you guys or something. But definitely you'll see anybody from the Dallas Assist, including their basketball and their football program out at their facility. And we encourage you guys to go check them out at the Oak Cliff Muscle Factory located in beautiful Dallas, Texas. Thank you guys.
Thank you.
I appreciate it so much. And we do have TRL, so let's go. This is our little thing we've been doing for social media. And back to the action as we switch off the split screen real quick. We've got the Dallas Assist coming down the court. Number 0 has switched over the point. Your score is 72-59. And Dallas Assist, no matter how much the athletic works have been able to produce on offense, they've been able to maintain this about 11-point lead. Let's see if the athletic works can start to chip into this lead as we continue on in this exhibition matchup of the Texas Basketball Association. Number 2, great pass. Great look, unable to convert. It out to the wing. Number 6 is going to reset the offense, pass it into the paint. He needs a drive, puts it up. Good shot. Number 2, he's been hot all day in the paint. Number 2 for Athletic Works, driving it down, still playing that point guard position. Number 1 coming up, and the length of the Dallas has really. You can really tell how the length of the Dallas Assist has been bothering the Athletic Works in this matchup. And with this core group on the court, the Athletic Works players, their core players have been hesitant to drive to the middle of the lane.
good, Javante. Much better. Much better. Bobblehead. I'm gonna record you. All right, at the free throw line for the third time today, number one for the Athletic Works. With the shot. Number one finds a little lane. He's driving, puts it up. Bad shot. And I don't like the shot selection coming from number one here in the third quarter. Up and under after going baseline. Number 12 makes it look easy with a nice up and under move. Number two's inches out to the wing. He's doubled, pass the ball up to number one, and that's been the problem. That's been the problem all day. He should have took the extra pass. Number five puts it up again. Nobody's taking the extra pass. You cannot play selfish. Two attempts from the paint, unable to convert. And let's see if they make the extra pass this time as he puts it up. And they're taking very difficult shots here by the Athletic Works. Pass it into the paint. Good defense. Pass it off number 15. Puts it in the air. Number 2 with the alley-oop. And your new score, 63-76. Pass it off the floor on the other end. Open, wide open layup, and he misses it. But draws the foul, it looks like. Well, it's not going to be a shooting foul. Gets the ball off to the wing. He takes the shot. He knocks the shot down. Number 77 drives down the court. Ball out to the wing. And he's being double teamed. And that's really the difference. I've seen this from both teams today. They get into a difficult position. Instead of trying to pass the ball out, they try to handle it themselves. And it's costed both teams on several possessions today. If the Athletic Works want to get back in this game, it's simple. They just need ball movement. They're not being outskilled, they're just not having enough patience. Number 11 takes it down the court. Finds some room in the paint, kicks it out to the three. Number 6 puts up a three, and it's well short. But with the steal, number 11 with another shot. Somebody has lost the shoe. We got a lost shoe on the court. Assist it down. Oh, and he's good for a three. Number 4 is going to take it up with the point. Swings it back out to 11. And they're just throwing up shots at this point. Good work in the paint. And that's what the Athletic Works need more. There you go. They got to get some ball movement on this one, and that's a bad shot. Ooh, he gets a three in my face. I guess they were tired of hearing to the commentary as he puts up a three. Your new score, 85-68. Oh, man. Number one goes baseline and dunks it good. Ball stolen. Stolen back. And foul on the play. And you see the magic that happens when you get in the paint as he's able to draw the foul. The athletic works don't need any more possessions where only one player touches the ball. Shots, two makes, and your score is 69-87. 18-point lead by the Dallas assist. 77 from 15. And he's good again. And your new score, 90-69. And with the steal, poor ball handling. And this has been some poor ball handling on this one. Dallas assists all over the athletic works here in this Texas Basketball Association exhibition game. Your score, 90-69. Dallas assists number four at the free throw line. This is the first one. And he misses both shots. Pass it number 23 in the paint. Passes it back out to the wing. And they have got to get in the paint. They pass it back into 23. He's going to go front the base. 11 with the rebound. And just with the doctor ordered some paint points. The new score, 71-90. Ill-advised shot, rebound, and he's able to draw the foul as the length and size advantage for the Dallas assist is starting to be more and more prevalent as the game goes on. Down both free throws. One of one. 71-91. 20-point lead by the Dallas assist. Beats the pick nicely. Gets in the paint. And one. As number four is able to get into the paint and make something happen. Thank you.
right, sorry about that momentary break in the commentary. This is Channing Humphrey back in the booth. Your score is 120-97. And that three was way short. Number four able to put the rebound back. Defense here in the fourth quarter, 22 to 99, 8 minutes and 22 seconds left to go here in the game. Number six is stopping to keep passing off to number four. Before makes a move, loses the ball, able to steal it back. Finds the ball in the paint, and the rebound's good after. Number 30 with the catch on the wing, he lets it go, unable to convert that one. Takes another three-point shot, unable to convert that one in the paint. And out of bounds off of Athletic Works. Ball inbounds to number zero. He's gonna take it down the court and run point. Immediately he goes into the paint and draws the foul. Kind of reminds you a little bit of Williams back in the day. Point guard for Utah. A bigger body playing point guard, it makes it a little bit easier for him to get that dribble drive penetration. He's been able to get in the paint all day. 7 minutes and 5 seconds and counting. Rolling this one. Your score is 24-99. Turnover, number 10 driving down the court and takes the long two. Maybe you should have took a step further back, but your new score is 101-24. Makes a man miss, a little bit of an elbow, but he's able to make the good pass and the postman gets the layup. Oh, if he makes a nifty move past the whole defense, coast to coast. Number zero at point guard, able to get some success here in the fourth quarter. I guess defense is off the table as both teams are putting up points in bunches. After the first miss of this little volley, good defense by the assist. They get the ball back. Number four, clear. Nobody blocking him to get to the basket. He passes it up for a better shot. 77 with the three. Your new score, 106. And that one was way off with the air ball. And number one just hasn't been that accurate from the field today. He needs to use more of his length and body size to try to get inside the paint. As number 77 just showed us how to. If there's such thing as a nice miss, number zero takes the three, airballs it. Number zero gonna go coast to coast again. Tripping foul. Oh, 109, your new score after the three-point shot. Another three by the Dallas assist, and this is becoming a shoot-around, as neither team have any interest in playing any defense. You can really see the fatigue on the court as the play has become a bit sloppy. And let's see what the call on the court is. Finds a little bit of an opening. Number four, after the sloppy start, gets all the way down to the other end, takes a shot. Good look, unable to convert. Number one, wide open, he's gonna take a three. And he's gonna drop a three. Your new score, 132 to 112. Another miss by the Dallas assist. 3 minutes and 18 seconds left to go into the paint. And their lead has almost been cut in half. And the fatigue is really starting to show on the Dallas assist sideline. If you just look across the court, the Athletical Works have six people on the bench. The Dallas assist only rotate four in, so we're having less personnel. The fatigue is starting to show on the court. Oh, he tries to ram it, but he misses the dunk. Dallas assistant got to maybe make a rotation, because you're getting very little effort on defense. And I believe he could have blocked that one, but fatigue forced that foul. Well, speaking of fatigue, if you're trying to get rid of your fatigue, you need to give the good folks out in Oak Cliff at the Muscle Factory a call. They've got Zumba classes. They've got all different types of athletic training. Give them a call. They're online. They are on Instagram. And they are open 24 hours. Muscle Factory in Oak Cliff, Texas. All right. Back in. Back in. And the point guard gets the rebound and goes back in. Number 15 up and over the back and puts it in for the conversion. Long pass, slapped off the glass, and there is zero effort. 1 minute, 42 seconds left to go. And fatigue has really set in for both teams. And the assists just need to slow this one down, set up a play, and play regular basketball, what they've been doing all night. And the easy layup. He calls for the ISO and he converts. And Athletic Works answers the call immediately. And they're in a stalemate right now. If the game keeps going the way it is, the assist was cruise to a victory. 45 seconds left to go. Trying to eat up as much clock as possible. There you go. 28 seconds left to go in this one. And the Dallas assist will look to run this one out. Last minute three from downtown. Good in garbage time.